Hello there. Thanks a lot for watching this video. I'm sure you are having a great day and it's a real pleasure to meet you through this virtual connect. Prasanna Ramaswamy is my name and I currently run a company called Finaltics. We specialize in accounting and financial analytics for startups and mid-sized organizations where the founders or the owner of the company can get business insights without much depending on chartered accountants or other financial specialists. So currently we are prototyping a software solution for them. But also we support them from the bookkeeping, account management, statutory requirements like taxation, GST and other activities. Prior to that, I was part of a company called Cognizant Technology Solutions for about 14 years. I was leading a practice called Enterprise Performance Management that specializes in CFO organization projects across the verticals. As a practice leader, I was responsible for building proposals, meeting customers and presenting the proposals, winning the deals, handling escalations, setting up the team, recruiting the team, and enhancing the competency with the latest skills. And when I was leaving the organizations, I was responsible for $30 million revenue and 300 associates across the globe. Even before that, I was part of Satyam Computers. So totally, my experience is around 17 years. Now, getting to the core capabilities, I was primarily working for CFO offices across the domains and industries. So I was working with functional users to understand the business demands and how it can be converted into IT solutions. So I also concentrating more on the planning and budgeting and consolidation processes. So in this, I have worked with the multiple verticals, but I just want to talk about two, three situations which is very close to my heart. I don't want to bore you with many, many situations. So first to start with a pharmaceutical or life science business, where I was involved in sales and marketing business to do the sales planning and cost planning together and get the brand level profit and loss statement for them. So it involves like how a sales volume to be derived, whether you want to take a previous year actuals or you want to do the competitor data or you want to take the patient level information, how you derive this, how a planning should happen at a brand or the pack level, how a generic brand should be planned or a brand that has to be launched 5 years later, how do you forecast now? Similarly, on the cost side, how a brand specific marketing expenses or overall administrative expenses has to happen. Similarly, on the region wise, so Europe region have a different concept, similarly Europe, APAC region will have a different concept, how it has to be collaborated and done things. So that's on the sales and marketing side of the business. Coming to the clinical side of the pharma business, I was working for another customer to define a 20 years old manual process into automated process. So in clinical trial process where you take the medicines to human and test it and see whether you have adverse effects, side effects are there and desired it and kindly approved for the end usage of that. So in this process, it's not just like that you start using it for a human being and other things. You will start to decide that how many patients are being considered, what are the regions I'm going to do, in that region what we are going to do that, how are you going to apply that. So all these things has to be cost factor. So that will be defined. Once that is done, they will decide who are the contractors and who should be paid how much and what is the duration for that and everything will be decided on this. COVID is an exceptional situation. Currently, it is happening very rapidly. Generally, it happens for 3 to 5 years or even 10 years it will happen so that the process will happen. So during this process, if there is a side effects or negative impacts, the compensation to be paid. So how that has to be absorbed in the cost. So all these things will be defined in the clinical trial process and this is completely automated using Oracle Hyperion and the users are able to achieve 80% efficiency over a period of time. So that's on the pharmaceutical business. On the other side, banking and financial segment, I was working for an Indian customer where closely working for loan sections. That they want to decide that how many delinquents or bad debts happening out of loans. They were not able to get daily morning status on what's happening across 200 plus branches in India, whether it is running properly or there's a delinquents are too much or bad debts is falling up. So we built a solution for them to integrate all the transactional data and build a customized calculation for them to derive that whether the last 1 week what happened, how it is performing. So are you going to get a net non-performing assets and all the things we will defend that. So that way they got a kind of descriptive analytics for them, which every day morning 6 o'clock they will be published to the users. On these things are more exciting, but most exciting work is for oil and gas industry. So coming to oil and gas industry, the complexity is very huge and starting from rigging and final distribution to the petrol pumps, the entire process involves multi-chain process and every business unit will have its own complications. So for example, as a finance guy, I should not be just worrying about what is the cost and what is the price I am going to defend. I should be even understanding that suppose the oil is being sent from one place to other place. During this process, due to pressure, how much loss is happening, how is impacting my margin. Similarly, which third party I should procure oil in case my capacity is not meeting my demands. On other side, once everything is produced, which terminal I should use for storing this oil, so that efficient terminals can be considered factors to be driven. And every product, how it has to be sold. It's not like just petrol and diesel. It's more components come out of the oil, how each component has to be stored. So the detailed understanding of this process and how the margin to be defined, this was completely defined, and we helped the customer to choose the products also to implement the solutions. That's the most exciting work for me and complex work for me. This is on the customer side. Coming to Center of Excellence, we built a chatbot for finance users. The primary reason for there is when a finance user, any finance company, any organization, finance group, will move their associates very fast between the business units. Because for them, the finance concept is core, only the business unit specific dynamics are there. So whenever the movement happens, the time taken to training, understanding the business unit specific complexity is large. So what we did here is we built a chatbot that can understand all the financial terminologies and everything. And whenever you just deploy it, it will directly go on hit the database and get you the data, and based on the result will be given. So time to understand the business unit specific data was faster using a chatbot, and it was much appreciated by the CFOs. So that's on the work whatever I did. Now I don't want to get into detail of every work, and it will get definitely bore you. So on other side, I am a professional portrait photographer. I run a studio and I go on people's house and do a photography. It's called Studio at Home. And also I am a part-time counseling psychologist. I'm a PhD diploma holder, and currently I'm pursuing my master's in counseling psychology to help the human for a better mental health. So that's all about me. And if you are looking for someone to manage your center of excellence or doing a transformation, whether it's a finance or non-finance, or enabling any digital activities for yourself or your customers, or running your offshore initiatives or any activities, so definitely call me. The numbers are here. My email IDs are here. So reach out to me. We can have an interaction and decide how we can take it further. So thanks once again for your time, and have a wonderful day. Let's definitely meet again. Thanks.